Hi everyone, Morgan with Event Answer here, and today I'm going to share with you a few tips on how to pick the right material for your next party backdrop. I'm also have a few tricks to show you on how to take any everyday object and turn it into a customized backdrop for your next party. So let's get right into it. Before you run out to the store and purchase any materials, what you want to do first is measure your backdrop frame. Behind me here, I have a custom PVC frame that I built meant for residential areas so it would fit inside my living room. So this is 7 feet tall and 8 feet across. You want to make sure you know exactly how tall your piece is, so we know that any of the materials that we're about to talk about, we know the exact size and length that we'll need for that. If you have purchased a backdrop frame, usually those are 8 or 10 feet tall and sometimes are customizable in height, so have in mind how tall you want that to be. The next thing you need to think about is how wide your backdrop is. Mine is 8 feet, and you want to know that because you don't want to buy just 8 feet wide worth of material, because your fabric is going to be pulled taut and it's just not very visually pleasing that way. When you have material, you want to be able to put gathers in it. These are the nice folds. They also hide a lot of crime, so if your fabric isn't absolutely square or perfect, gathers will hide that. So you want to make sure that when we're purchasing material, we are getting the width of our backdrop plus a couple more feet, so we have enough material to gather and make it look beautiful. There are a lot of standard options available. If you're not feeling crafty and just want to purchase something, there's lots of event websites out there that sell pipe and drape backdrops or backdrop fabrics. One of my favorite places to purchase from is efavormarts.com. They're really reasonable in price and come in lots of colors. So if you're looking for an easy, ready to purchase option, those are great resources to check into. But if you're wanting maybe some more customized options, you can look into curtains. I'm talking regular household drapes. Now, there's a couple things you want to look for if you're going to go this route. You want to make sure that your piece has a header in it. So this is a pocket that's sewn into the top that usually your curtain rod would go through. And instead of a curtain rod, we're using the top pipe of our pipe and drape or backdrop stand. One thing you want to keep in mind is you really want a header and not grommets. If you go the grommet route, what happens is the supporting pipe of your backdrop is seen through the fabric weaving in and out using those grommets. So unless you're going to be using balloons or paper flowers or some kind of decoration to hide that top bar of your pipe and drape, you want to stay away from grommets and stick with something that has a header in it. Now, the one thing about this curtain here is this header is not big enough to fit over the pipe of my backdrop stand. So whenever you're purchasing curtains, make sure your header is deep enough for your backdrop stand. The next material I really enjoy using as backdrops are your standard tablecloths. I love to pick these up on event websites, kind of like eFavorMart or Event Decor Direct, something like that. Linentablecloth.com is another good one. You can pick this up really inexpensively, and it's a great way to get lots of fabric for a little cost. And plus, it's already hemmed, so you're not having to worry about raw edges or frayed edges with your material. So a lot of times I will use a tablecloth and then put a header in it, which I'll show you in a moment here, so it'll fit my backdrop. If you can't find anything pre-made that fits the design aesthetic that you're looking for, you can always purchase fabric. I love purchasing fabric because it comes in really wide segments and you can get it in any length you need. So say I had a 10-foot backdrop here and I couldn't find a household curtain that would fit it, I can go to my local fabric store and find the exact color and texture or pattern that I want, buy as many yards as I need, and then I can go ahead and put my own header in it, which I'll show you here. So with this green piece of fabric, what I did was I laid it out flat on the floor, and with the top edge, I folded it down a couple inches, and I'm going to pin in a header. Now you can use corsage pins or safety pins, that's a personal preference, but you want this to be the back side of your curtain that you're putting the pins in. Now, if your curtain is too long for your backdrop stand, you can shorten it by folding even more fabric over and then pinning your header in to shorten it. So it gives you a little bit of customization options here. But once you've laid it flat and you've got it to the exact measurements you want, start pinning across. And just make sure you're pinning far enough down that you can get your backdrop stand through that pocket. Now, if you have a sewing machine and enjoy sewing, you can absolutely put this under a sewing machine and sew your own pockets into this easily. I do love the pinning option because it allows me to customize my backdrops with lots of different fabrics without committing full time to that choice. So I can unpin this and use it as a tablecloth next week if I don't want it as a backdrop anymore. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. Never feel like you're limited by the materials you can buy in this store that are specifically meant to be a backdrop. You can use all kinds of different fabrics, tablecloths, curtains, blankets, whatever material you see that would fit your designs. Feel free to use them, and I hope that the tips that you've learned here today will help you accomplish that. If you enjoyed this video, give it a big thumbs up. I'd love to see you in a future video, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of those future projects and parties. We'll see you in a future video. Bye!